Welcome, welcome. Good morning, good morning. Just land. Take a second. Find yourself. Just see where you are this morning. See how you are this morning. Or this evening, if it happens to be evening time when you're watching this. Allowing yourself take a breath in. Sighing that breath out. Being. Just allowing yourself be present. And I've been doing a lot of work over the last 2 days, planning and class planning and everything for all the classes that are coming up in May. And they're really around this whole idea of transitioning back. So we kind of got landed into this pretty quickly. And while our bodies went into shock coming into this sort of lockdown, at least we were also home and safe and we could hide under the covers. And for a lot of us, it took a couple of weeks, maybe for work, or a couple of days even for work, to settle into a rhythm. But now we know that the change is happening, that sometime soon-ish, kind of, we're not really sure where. So all of this uncertainty that now exists is all going to be coming back up again, because we're 6 weeks in lockdown now, in closed down and lockdown. So this has become our new norm. So you'll notice that your nervous system has settled. And for a lot of us, bar specific things, that we've kind of got, this has become our norm. So now as we start to shift back out and change, and even, so we talk about transition. So this is, we're not actually transitioning yet, but our mentally, emotionally, and our nervous system is conscious that a transition is coming. So I always talk about how the transitions are where the magic is. So that's what I'll be working on in all the classes in the next month or the next few weeks, is looking at that transition. But I want to bring your awareness to it now so you can start to catch it. So today, physically, in the physical movement, play in transitions, but also just over the next while, see that you notice, when is your nervous system sort of sparking again, and what are the kind of thoughts that are there, and then what I'm hoping to do is put together a few meditations and stuff like that. So if there's anything that you want me to include, let me know. But transitions, that's the word that I want you to play with today. So with that in mind, just take a centering breath here before you once again transition. Just land here and then transition. So how do you get from the seated position to come to standing even, and see what that's like in your body. Can you find it smooth? Is it jarring? Once you come to standing, new transition, change of position. How is that? Had you got comfortable sitting and did you not want to stand? Coming into this free movement. Do you remember in the beginning that this space, this moment to be with your body, to be free, was probably a little bit daunting? How is it now? Once you got used to it, how is it? And now again, I'm going to transition you. We're going to transition from that free movement to come to structured movement. Movement that suits your body, absolutely, and that suits your humor today. And structured, so come into stillness again. Finding your feet again. Every time you change, re-anchoring, finding the root, finding the ground beneath you. That's what we're going to be working with next week, is keeping the ground beneath us. As you inhale, come long. So as you exhale, you start to roll. First roll, have a little wriggle in your roll, maybe. Inhaling, coming up. Maybe have a little wriggle here. Exhaling, and you're coming back down again, coming a little bit deeper. Inhaling, coming up. If you need to stop and pause in any of these positions, remember that's what you do. And you reach onto your toes this time. We'll come down and back up one more time. Coming down. Roll, curve, softness, fine flow and softness. Strong legs as you re-enter. Reaching up, out, and maybe opening shoulders. Maybe letting head back. Try not to have the belly pop in that as you come back down. This time we're going to stay down into flat back. So power from your feet through your legs. Unwinding to flat back, long back. Exhaling, coming into your squat. From your squat, looking to step back. Playing in our lunge. How do you want to play in your lunge today? How deep do you want to make it? How shallow do you want to make it? Releasing through these hips, glutes, hamstrings, calves. Finding your own rhythm as you play, moving forward and back. Pausing where you want to pause. Resting where you want to rest. And then in your own time, whenever you're ready, reaching the back foot into the ground so you can find the rebound effect. The feet together from here through your squat. Reaching for the stars and yogi's choice, opening up or not as much as you want. Let your breath settle, and when you're ready, inhale to tall. Exhale to curl. Inhale to open. These are all transitions, actually. Opening up. Exhale, curling back. Coming a little bit deeper. Inhale, expanding again. Reaching again. Opening. Exhaling, this time we're going to stay down. So as you come down, through your feet into flat back. All the time being grounded. Exhaling, coming down into your lunge, from your lunge, stepping with the opposite foot, if you can remember what that is. Coming back. Feeling your way through it. Different side, different leg, different set of muscles, different set of everything, really. How is it? Moving as you want to move. Easing as you want to ease. When you're ready, leaning into the support that is there beneath you. Lean into your support, into the ground, the back foot. As you step forward, back together, and then through squat, grounded, allowing you reach for the stars. And back to prayer. Letting your breath settle. Noticing the acceleration in your breath. Maybe a little bit of heat. We go again. Inhaling length. Exhaling curl. Softness, softness, because we are strong. Inhaling, releasing, expanding. Maybe even reaching on your toes. See how it feels to be unstable on your toes. Exhaling, coming back down. We're going to flat back. So powering from the ground through the support of the feet through to the tippy top of the head. Exhaling back again into the ground and stepping, jumping, or whatever way to find yourself into plank. So in plank, you've changed. You now need support from the hands as well as the feet. So plank can be just on hands and feet, or you can take the support of your knees. Put your knees on the ground. See how it is. Taking a moment. How is the core? How is the center? How is your energy today? How is it to be supported on your arms? Oh, stop talking, Laura, let me come down. How is it to be supported on your arms and then knees chest, chin coming to the ground. Releasing, coming long and then to up. Coming only what feels nice in your back. No pinching. Do less to feel more. Nose to the ground. Coming with a flat back, protecting that lower back through hair. Into dog. First dog of the day. Maybe. Walk it out. Having a little bend of one knee, a little look under the opposite arm, feeling that whole side body. Back to center and doing it for the other side. And then whenever you're ready, getting this ski slope effect, really feeling the support of the hands on the ground, from the hands growing long through the arms, through the spine, through to the butt. Soft knees initially and then head to open up the knees, only as much as suits your body this morning. Memories from yesterday are memories. Dreams about what you can do tomorrow are dreams. Be present in your body as it is right now. And then in your own time, when you're ready, stepping with the right, meeting with the left, and coming on back up. And when you're ready, we'll just go again on the other side. Inhaling to length, exhaling to curl. Inhaling, expanding. How much do you want to expand? How high do you want to reach? Reaching for the stars. Exhaling, coming down. Releasing down, coming to flat back. Rhythm is now coming to this. Stepping back with the left. Hands are on the ground, so you're ready to take the support. Meeting with the right. And this time, just lowering yourself down. Long, releasing the shoulders back and head forward before you rise up. Releasing down, pushing through hands, engaging belly, coming back to dog. See what it is you want to do in dog this time. Taking your choice, stillness or movement. Taking a breath or two, then in stillness. Length, stability, strength, all in once. And when you're ready, step in with the left. Meeting with the right. Coming down to come up. And back to prayer. When you're ready, we're going to keep going, this time into dolphin and puppy. Inhaling to length, exhaling to curl. Inhaling for the stars on your toes if you want. Exhaling, coming back down. We're going to stay down this time into flat back. From flat back into squat. And from squat, we're going to step back into dog. So not as far, just into dog. So a little step. From dog, choose how you're getting down to dolphin. Maybe you can come onto your elbows, maybe you come onto your knees first and then come back up. Either is perfect. And then take a moment in dolphin. Be with it. If you hate dolphin, be with it. If dolphin is not for you because it's too tight on your shoulders, don't be with it, come out of it. Do hair pose instead. If you like dolphin, have a little walk in. Walk back out again. Then regardless, coming to your knees. Noticing how all those emotions about a pose, they're just emotions. As long as you're safe, the rest is fine. From here, on your knees, but in the air, walking your hands out and we're coming to puppy.
So puppy, head active between your arms and this business of rounding your back, so not letting your back dip. And so finding puppy. Checking it out. Maybe have a little wiggle in your tail because you know you're happy burying your bone. Maybe walk your shoulders, hands out a little bit so you can roll your shoulders out. So it's like you're taking your arm and rotating it outwards. See what it feels like. Explore the sensations in it. Is it nice on your shoulders to do that or not? Does that give you a little bit more support or a little bit less? Can you get length? Take your tail a long way away. Get length through your spine as you're in this pose. And then releasing down, coming to child or to hare. Have a little wriggle. Have a little moment. And here is an opportunity for a transition again. I have no idea how much space you have, but I don't have enough space here to transition. I need to move. And from here, I'm going to roll to the side to bring me onto my back. I just like these kind of playful transitions. I get to roll, play, be. So see how it is for you. Have a little roll, have a little wriggle. Coming into your twist, whatever way that feels like for you. Easing, releasing, being. Finishing your twist by hooking your knees into your chest. Finishing all movements with a symmetric movement. So you're kind of bringing yourself back in together, this little egg. And from this egg, rolling over onto your side and coming to seat it. Attacked by a printer. God, I hope it's not a really important document for my husband that I've just turned off. But anyway, meanwhile, you are centered and seated. Coming once more to your breath. As always, coming back to this fantastic breath that is with us. Finding the breath. Being in your breath. Allowing yourself be still. And today I'm going to read you a story. You see, I'm practicing playing planning classes for the kids, and they're going to be stories as well. So. I thought, why not let us have a story this morning? So simply be in your breath, in your body. Allow my words come if you like them, and if not, just ignore them and just be with your breath. This is a story from The Mastery of Love by Don Miguel, which is part of the Four Agreements, that kind of, that same thing. And it's about love and it's about fear. For me, this world, we have a choice as we re-enter to come from a place of love, not even as we re-enter, but even now. Do we come from a place of love or fear? So this is what his take is on love.
Magical kitchen. Imagine you have a magical kitchen in your home. In that magical kitchen, you can have any food you want from any place in the world in any quantity. You never worry about what you eat. Whatever you want for, you can have at your table. You are very generous with your food. You give your food unconditionally to others because you want, not because you want something from them. Whoever comes to your home, you just feed them for the pleasure of sharing your food. And your house is always full of people who come to eat from your food, food from your magical kitchen. One day someone knocks on your door and it's a person with a pizza. You open the door and the person looks at you. Hey, do you want to see this pizza? I'll give you this pizza if you let me control your life. If you do just whatever I want you to do, you are never going to starve because I can bring you pizza every day. You just have to be good to me. Can you imagine your reaction? In your kitchen, you can have the same pizza, even better. Yet, this person comes and offers you food. If you just do what he wants you to do, you're going to laugh and say, no, thank you. I don't need your food. I have plenty of food. You can come into my house if you like and eat whatever you want. And you don't have to do anything. But I don't believe I'm going to do what you want me to do. No one, thank you, can manipulate me with food. Now imagine the opposite. Several weeks have gone by and you haven't eaten. You're starving. You have no money in your pocket to buy food. Then the person comes to you with pizza and says, hey, there's food here. You can have this food if you just do what I want you to do. You can smell the food. You're starving. You decide to accept the food and do whatever the person asks of you. You eat some food. He says, if you want more, you can have more. But you have to keep doing what I want you to do. You have food today, but tomorrow you may not have food. So you agree. You agree to do whatever you can for food. You can become a slave to food because you need food, because you don't have it. Then after a certain time, you start to have debts. You say, what am I going to do without pizza? I cannot live without pizza. What if my partner decides to give the pizza to someone else? My pizza. Now imagine instead of food, we're talking about love. You have an abundance of love in your heart. And I'd add the word wisdom. You have love not just for yourself, but for the whole world. So much that you don't need to anyone else's love. You share your love without condition. You don't love if. You're a millionaire in love. And if someone knocks on your door and says, hey, I have love for you here. You can have my love if you just do whatever I want you to do. When you're full of love, what's going to be your reaction? You'll laugh and say, thank you, but I don't need your love. I have the same love here in my heart. I'll share my love with you if you like. But what's going to happen if you're starving from love? If you don't have love in your heart and someone says, you want a little love? You can have my love if you just do what I want you to do. You're starving for love and you taste the love. You're going to do whatever you can for that love. You can even be so needy that you give your whole soul away for just a little attention. Your heart is like that magical kitchen. If you open your heart, you already have all the love, and I'm adding wisdom, you need. There's no need to go around the world begging for love or wisdom. Please, someone love me. I'm so lonely. I'm not good enough for love. I need someone to love me to prove that I am worthy of love. We all have love right inside us, but we don't see this love. Selfishness and fear comes from a poverty of the heart, from the belief that love is not about abundance. We can't become selfish and fearful when we believe that maybe tomorrow we won't have any pizza. But when we know that our heart is like a magical kitchen, we are always generous and completely unconditional. Now Miguel's loving magical kitchen, he's speaking about it in terms of love, the opposite to love being fear. And so during the day, during the coming weekend, I invite you to just notice how many things, how many places, people, how much of the world we try to sell this idea of lack of abundance, of less than, of needing to do something in order to, conditionality. Notice when you forget that you do not have, that you do have a magical kitchen. That your heart is full of love. Your being is full of wisdom. And at each moment, all that we need to do is connect, remember, and from there we know the exact and perfect response to each and every situation. And so I invite you to notice if there's anything you want to bring with you from this morning's practice through the day. And then releasing, starting to move, starting to once again transition. See this transition? We make this transition every day. Every day. And so we go, do what you need to do, and we meet again for our ocean. Taking our hands to our heart and bowing, offering peace. Om Shanti.